वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेसन ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश कुमार भारती. नेम ऑफ द पोम इज एनिमल्स, रिटन बाय वॉल्ट विटमन. अबाउट पोएट वॉल्ट विटमन, 1819 to 1892. अ मेजर फिगर इन अर्ली अमेरिकन पोएट्री इन an age when all poetry was rhymed and metrical, Whitman made a break with tradition and wrote a revolutionary new kind of poetry in free verse. He was non-conformist in all respects, including his social life. The poet tells us that he feels more at home with animals than humans, who he finds complicated and false. Let's see poem and its explanation. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid. Here placid means calm and peaceful. And self-content. Content means keep up control. I stand and look at them long and long. The poet says that he wants to live in the world of animals. Here we can say that the poet finds the world of animals better than that of human beings. He further says that he finds animal more peaceful than humans. He says so because animals are not running after worldly things like human beings. They are calm and have no greed for worldly things or any kind of achievements. They are self-content, means they are happy with life and never interfere in the lives of others. Humans have the habit of interfering in lives of others. So poet thinks that animals are better than humans for being calm and not interfering in the matters of others. The poet further says that these are the reasons why he stands still and looks at the animals for a very long time. They do not sweat. Here sweat means complain. Whine means cry. About their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. Sins means wrongdoing. They do not make mistake discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented. Here demented means mad with the mania of owning things. The poet says that unlike humans, animals don't complain of any misery. They never cry out loud like humans do to show what they have lost. They never stay awake in the night crying in repentance for their wrongdoings. This means that animals are different from human beings because they don't show anger or grief if something wrong happens with them. He further says that animals are very truthful because they never boast of their good deeds done in the name of God. He says so because most of the human beings do this. They try to show their good deeds and religiousness to others. They do so in order to gain popularity among their fellows. So the poet thinks that animals never irritate him by doing such things just to gain some praise from their fellow people. He feels that the animals are not dissatisfied like humans. They stay happy with whatever they have. They never run behind worldly things. They never try to possess things of comfort or luxury. He says that none of them is mad behind owning the worldly things. Not one kneels. Here kneels means bow down. To another, not to his kind that lived thousands of years ago, not one in respectable or unhappy over the whole earth. So they show their relations to me and I accept them. They bring me tokens. Here tokens means qualities of myself. They events means show, reveal them plainly in their possession. Possession means ownership of something. Here the poet says that he has never seen any animal showing his devotion to anyone by bowing down in front of the person. They never do so even for their ancestors. They do not show devotions towards God like humans do. No one among them is more respectable or important as we have in human society. In human beings, rich people are generally given more importance and are treated with more respect as compared to the poor. But in the society of animals, they never do so. They never give more or less importance to any other animal. Everyone in the animal world is happy. They are not like human beings who find themselves the happiest or the saddest person on the earth. Further, the poet says that animals are more honest in showing their relations with other animals. Here, he wants to say that animals use other animals as their food and they never try to hide this. Whereas human beings show that they have a nice and friendly relations with others, though the reality is opposite. The poet says that he accepts the fact that animals are true towards showing their relation with other animals. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago? Negligently drop them. Here, negligently means carelessly. So, at last, the poet introspects himself and says that from where the animals got those good qualities. He further questions himself that where his own good qualities are gone. Did he left them or had carelessly lost them somewhere? The qualities that were found in human beings in the past, like innocence, kindness, truthfulness, are now seen in animals. He wonders that humans gave up these qualities and they have been passed on to the animals. Now, summary of the poem. In the poem Animals, the poet has described his will to become an animal because he thinks animals are far better than human beings. Human beings are greedy and full of jealousy against each other, but animals are calm and self-content. The animals are happy with what they have. They never complain about miseries and sorrows. On the other hand, human beings complain about their miseries. They give more importance to the rich and strong people, stay restless because of their wrongdoings and behind the luxuries things of this world. Whereas animals are honest about their relations and don't give importance to a particular class. They live a life which is full of honesty and less of greed and jealousy. Hope everybody understand this poem. Thank you.